फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज मिस्टर विपुल संसारे। वंस अगेन वेलकम यू इन अवर न्यू वीडियो लेक्चर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ टू डिफरेंट प्लांट्स, दैट इज एस्पैरागस एंड जिंजर। सो दिस एस्पैरागस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज शतमूली और शतावरी। दीज आर द ड्राइड रूट्स ऑफ एस्पैरागस रैसेमोसस, बिलोंगिंग टू फैमिली लिलियासी। सो दीज आर द ड्राइड रूट्स। नाउ दिस asparagus contains the steroidal saponin as a major chemical constituent. So which are the different steroidal saponins are present in asparagus? So this asparagus contains shatavarin 1, shatavarin 2, shatavarin 3 and shatavarin 4. That is four different subtypes of steroidal saponins. Then also contains the flavonoids, that is quercetin and rutin. Two different flavonoids are present. This asparagus is used as a galactagogue, then also used as a diuretic, then tonic, then anti-oxytocin, then anti-rheumatic and nerve tonic. So these are the different uses of asparagus root. Just see the microscopy of asparagus root. So here the transverse section of asparagus root I have represented. So this transverse section is divided into the different zones. So first is epidermis. This epidermis is a single layer, elongated thin wall cells layer. So this epidermis is nothing but a single layer, elongated thin wall cells layer, contains the few hair rootlets where the root hairs are originated from epidermis. Next, the second major layer, that is cortex. So this cortex major portion contains the few layers of upper part of cortex, contain few layers of thick wall cholelchyma. So this cortex contain few layers of thick wall cholelchyma, that is thin wall cells. Cholelchyma is nothing but a thin wall cells. Then lower part of cortex contain thin wall parenchymatous cells. So two different types of cells are present in cortex, that is cholelchyma as well as parenchymatous cells. Then next important layer, that is endodermis. So this endodermis contain lignified parenchymatous cells, in endodermis. Next, the pericycle. Pericycles contain the various cells, that is alternative strands of xylem and phloem in pericycle. Next, just see the phloem. This phloem is non-lignified. Phloem is non-lignified and appear like a bunch of grapes. You can see here, the phloem is non-lignified cells containing bunch of grapes. They are appear like a bunch of grapes. Next, see the other important layer, that is xylem. This xylem contain the lignified parenchymatous cells, in xylem. Then next important thing, these are vessels are also there in TS of asparagus and various pits. These pits contain the parenchymatous cells, both types of parenchymatous cells, that is lignified as well as non-lignified parenchymatous cells. So these are the different microscopic characteristics of asparagus. The major thing, that is cortex, then endodermis, then phloem, then xylem, then pits, and epidermis, that is top layer containing various root hairs. So these are the major microscopic characteristics of asparagus. Just see the powder microscopy. So this powder microscopy of asparagus shows the epidermis, which are thin wall cells with hair rootlets, as we have discussed earlier. Then lignified parenchyma. This lignified parenchyma is nothing but a thin wall lignified parenchymatous cells. Then xylem vessels, which are also lignified. Then most important thing, the calcium oxalate, starch grains and fibers are absent in asparagus. Microchemical test, the lignified cells in asparagus shows the red color in presence of fluoroglucinol and concentrated HCl. Just see the chemical test. So this asparagus contains the flavonoids, which are identified using Shinoda test, which shows the pink color in presence of the reagent. Now when this extract of asparagus treated with lead acetate reagent, it produces the yellow PPT due to the presence of flavonoids and phenolic compounds. Next, when the extract treated with potassium permanganate solution, the decolorization of the potassium permanganate solution, the purple color get decolorized due to the presence of reducing substances and flavonoids in asparagus. Next, when the aqueous extract vigorously shake for a few minutes, it produces the foam due to the presence of saponins in asparagus. So these are the different chemical tests used for the identification of asparagus. The second important plant, that is ginger. So the ginger is also known as Jamaica ginger or gingivar. These are the dried rhizomes, the most important thing. Asparagus are the root, whereas the gingers are the rhizomes. So these are the dried rhizomes of gingivar officinale, belonging to family Gingiberaceae. It contains alkaloids as a major chemical constituent, then volatile oils which contain cineol and citral as a terpenes, also contain resinous matter. Then pungent principle in ginger is gingerol, and the two constituents, that is gingiberol and gingiberin, are responsible for characteristics aroma of the ginger. So these are the various chemical constituents. It is used as a carminative and stimulants. Just see the transverse section of ginger. So transverse section, the first important layer, top layer, that is cork. So two different cork, that is outer cork and inner corks, are there in ginger. So this outer cork, these are the dark brown color parenchymatous cells, which are irregularly arranged in outer cork, whereas the inner cork contain colorless parenchymatous cells, which are radially arranged in regular rows. So these are the two difference between the outer cork and inner cork. Outer cork contain the irregularly arranged parenchymatous cells, whereas the inner cork contain regularly arranged, that is radial arrangement of parenchymatous cells. Whereas outer cork is brown color and inner cork is colorless. So this is the major difference. Then contain the cortex. So cortex contain the fibrovascular bundle. So fibrovascular bundle, this vascular bundle is collateral and conjoint and close. It basically contains, the fibrovascular bundle contains a group of scleral chymatous fibers, partially covers the vascular bundles of cortex. So this fibrovascular bundle contains scleral chymatous fibers, which covers the vascular bundles of cortex. Second important thing, it contains the xylem vessels. These xylem vessels are spiral and reticulate thickening, the spiral arrangement of xylem vessels. Then also contains the fibers which are peated and lignified fibers. So these are the important microscopic characteristics. Then cortex also contain yellowish color or yellowish brown color oleoresins cells, which contain different oleoresins. Then also contain the starch grains, that is important microscopic characteristics of ginger, that is starch grains. The last zone, that is ground tissue, which are separated from the middle zone through endodermis. So endodermis is a single layer radially arranged cells, that is in endodermis, single layer radially arranged cells. In the bottom zone, that is ground tissue, which contains the vascular bundle. This vascular bundle is basically ring of vascular bundle below the endodermis. Then also contain the starch grains. The starch grains are flattened and rectangular ovate grains containing starch, which is identified using iodine solution. So these are the important microscopic characteristics of ginger rhizomes. Just see the powder microscopy. First, that is parenchyma is there. So this parenchyma is nothing but parenchymatous cells with iodoblast, contain yellow brown oleoresinous body or starch granules. This oleoresinous body contains the oleoresins. Second, the fibers, these are the large thin wall fibers are present. Then starch grain, these are flattened and ovate starch grains are present in ginger. The most important thing, the calcium oxalate crystals are absent in ginger. Just see the microchemical test. So vascular bundle, which is present in the ginger, shows the red color in presence of fluoroglucinol and concentrated HCl. The starch grain shows the blue color in presence of iodine. These are the two important microchemical tests. Just see the various types of adulterants which are mixed in ginger. So first is exhausted ginger. These exhausted gingers are low quality and low purity gingers, which are detected by purity test according to official books. The second adulterant, that is wormy ginger, these are detected by presence of insect remains in the ginger powder. The third adulterant, that is unscrap ginger, these unscrap ginger are detected by the presence of cork cells in unscrap ginger. And last adulterant, that is capsicum powder. This capsicum powder is detected by a simple test, that is boiling with 5% potassium hydroxide solution. So on boiling of pure ginger powder with potassium hydroxide solution, it loses its pungency. The pungent principles in the ginger are basically degraded. But if the capsicum powder is mixed in the ginger powder, the pungency remains even after the boiling with 5% KOH. So this is the important test for identification of capsicum powder as an adulterant in ginger powder. So these are the different adulterants. Now just see the question. The pungent principle in the ginger is, this question has appeared in GPAT. So the pungent principle in the ginger is the gingerol, as we have discussed. Next, the decomposition product of gingerol on boiling with 2% KOH. So this gingerol is responsible for the pungency of the ginger. So on boiling with 2% KOH, this gingerol is basically decomposed, and due to the decomposition of the gingerol, the pungency of ginger is lost. So the decomposition product is the gingerone, The gingerone is a decomposition product. Although this gingerol is a pungent, but it is very less pungent than gingerol. That's why the pungency of ginger is lost. The shagol is other constituent, that is oily constituents, is there in ginger. Then cineol is constituents in volatile oil, that is in terpenes. So the correct answer is gingerone, that is the decomposition product of gingerol on boiling with 2% KOH. And next important thing, on boiling the ginger with 5% KOH, the pungency is completely lost. The 2% KOH, in presence of 2% KOH, the pungency is reduced. But in presence of 5% KOH, the pungency is completely lost. So these are the different microscopic characteristics of asparagus and ginger. Thank you.